everyone, it's Eleanor from Art with Eleanor, and today I'm going to be showing you how to paint pink clouds on a light bulb. But before we get into the video, if you could like and subscribe, I'd really appreciate it. And without further ado, let's get into it. I started by painting the light bulb with a base layer of white. As you will see, to get the coverage I wanted, I ended up doing several layers of white paint before starting to add the colour on top. One tip I can give you for mastering the first few layers is to make sure you do not mix too much water into the paint, as otherwise it won't stick to the glass very well. You also need to make sure each layer is completely dry before adding the next, because it could disturb the lower layers if the paint hasn't fully dried. Whilst I'm painting these base layers, I just wanted to say sorry if the lighting changes a bit during this video. I'm trying a new setup, so I was fiddling around with the lighting to see what would be best. The next step is to start adding colour to the bulb. Unlike my previous bulb video, I wanted to create a gradient of colour for the background, rather than just starting with a flat base colour and adding to it. The idea for this bulb is that the top of the bulb is the night sky with stars on it, and the bottom is bright blue, almost like daylight, where the pink clouds will go. I quite like the idea of this painting being quite mystical or magical, as a scene would never happen in real life. So, like the white base, I did several layers of the blue to black gradient, just so I could get it absolutely perfect. As you can see, I'm blending using just one sponge, without cleaning it between layers. I personally find this quite a good method to use when blending the sponges, as it allows the colours to mix together a bit easier, and you don't have to worry about washing your sponge out and making the paint too wet. I also just wanted to say that the sponge I'm using is literally just a washing up sponge cut up into pieces, so you don't need anything particularly fancy to do this painting. Whilst I'm painting this blue gradient in, I just wanted to explain a few of the questions I've been getting asked about my last light bulb video. For that video, I was painting on a light bulb which had blown in my room, and this is one of the reasons why I didn't show everyone what the light bulb looked like on. Also, I am not making these light bulbs to actually be used, just for a decorative purpose. This is because the acrylic paint I am using could either melt from the heat of the bulb, or apparently it could explode the glass in the bulb, which really would not be good. So sorry if you came here to see the bulb on, I personally don't want to risk it. If that is something you would like to see, leave a comment down below and I can have a look into getting some paint that is made for painting glass and light bulbs that would be able to withstand the heat of the bulb. Step for this painting process is to add in the pink clouds. As you can see, I cut up my sponge into smaller triangular chunks so I could have a separate sponge for each of the colours. I used a combination of pink, light pink and white to create the clouds, which I decided to have around just the bottom half of the light bulb. The process of painting the clouds did vary a little, depending on how opaque I wanted each cloud to be. But the basic process included starting with a faint layer to map out the main shape of the cloud. I would then go back and forth with the different colours to create some more tonal variation in the clouds. Generally, I worked with the darker colours being more concentrated at the bottom of the cloud, and if I wanted the cloud to be opaquer, I would start with the white paint first to create a strong base layer. To make the clouds look fluffy and wispy, I got rid of most of the paint on the sponge and lightly dabbed it around the edge to create the right texture for that type of cloud. I'd finished painting the cloud, I decided to add some little stars to the top of the light bulb. I did this using my smallest paintbrush, and I also used my finger to smudge the paint a bit, so it wasn't quite as bright white. Of course, you could thin down the white paint and spray it at the bulb by flicking it off your paintbrush, but I didn't want to risk getting paint everywhere in my uni accommodation. And that's the end of the tutorial. If you guys liked how this light bulb turned out and want to have it for yourself, I'm selling it on my Etsy for just £10. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this tutorial, be sure to give it a like and subscribe for more art content like this. And if you want to see more behind the scenes action to my YouTube channel, be sure to follow my Instagram @artwitheleanor. Bye!